So now let's talk about tautology versus contradiction. Right away, I will tell you, a tautology is something that is always true. It is what is. On the other hand, a contradiction is something that's never true. And I would like to put it as, this is always going to be false. So pay close attention to the truth table. It's always going to give you true for a tautology, and it's always going to give you false when we have a contradiction. So let me show you guys some examples. Perhaps the most famous one is, let's say, piece of statement. And let's talk about an or statement here. And I'm also going to put down a negation of P. So here we have P or not P. And if you think about it, if P stands for it's going to rain today, not P will stand for it's not going to rain today. The whole thing is telling you that it's either going to rain or not going to rain. And you will be like, duh, that's obvious. So that's for sure always true. So this right here is a tautology. But let's see from a truth table. Right here, we have P only. So we just need two rows here, either true or false. And then I'm also going to write down na P, which I'll just negate this. So we will have false, true. And then finally, P or na P. And sometimes it's helpful, like to me, it's just like you don't look at the top anymore, but just remember what we are doing. This is an or statement, so have a look. True or false, that will be true. As long as one of them is true, then the whole thing is true. Next, false or true, that will also be true. So as you can see, the final column from the truth table is always true, so this right here indeed is a tautology. Now, I'll give you guys another one. Let's look at example number two. What if I give you P implying not P? This is an implication. So now if you think about it, if P stands for it's going to rain today, not P will mean it's not going to rain today. The whole thing right here is saying, if it rains today, then it's not going to rain today. It's kind of like, well, if it rains today, then it's not going to rain today. It's like, of course it's true. But you have to be careful, because what if this right here is false and give you something that's true? Again, we are going to do it the safe way. Let's look at this from a truth table. P, not P. Just two rows. True, false, false, true. And right here, it really, really helps me if you just don't look at the top anymore, but you have to remember we are doing an implication. True implying false, that will be false. But next, if it's false implying true, this right here is actually true. Remember, we have an implication. So if the first condition right here is false, then it doesn't matter what the conclusion is. The whole thing will be true. So this right here doesn't give you always true and doesn't give you always false. So this is neither a tautology nor a contradiction. Number three, how about let me just say P and not P. This is an and statement. If it rains today and it's not raining today, that it's not possible, right? I'm not talking about a certain area, but if it's Sunday, and it's not Sunday, that's not possible. Anyways, if you look at the truth table, P, not P, and then true, false, false, true, and then P and not P. They have to be both true in order to be true. True and false, that's false. False and true, that's false. So this is a contradiction because we get always false. Now, let me show you guys some more complicated examples. Number four, we have P implying Q or Q implying P. Set a truth table to be sure, right? So here we go. This time we have P and Q, so we need a total of 4 rows from here. So I will just write true, true, false, false, and then true, false, true, false. So firstly, let's work this out. That's P implying Q. Okay, true implying true, that is true. True implying false, that is false. False implying true, that is true. False implying false, that is true. So that's this right here. And we should also get this right here, right? And I'm actually just going to write this down again. I think it's easier. So just Q, P. I'm just going to copy them down. So this is true, false, and this is true, false, false. Okay, here we're looking at Q implying P. So I'm looking at this direction. I think it's just easier this way. So here we go. True implying true, that is true. False implying true, that is true. True implying false, that is false. Lastly, false implying false, that is true. So now, we're looking at this column and this column, and then we're doing an OR, right? So let me just write down P implying Q or Q implying P. True or true, that is true. False or true, that will be true. True, false, that is true. And lastly, true or true, we get true. Aha, everybody is true right here. So this right here is totally a tautology. Yep. All right, number 5. Here we have not. Here is P implying Q and Q. So this is not obvious at all. And let's go ahead and set our truth table. So once again, 4 rows. So P, Q, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. So true, true, false, false, true, false, true, false. Here, let's do P implying Q. So that will be true, false, false, mean true and true. Then we will have to do not P implying Q. So we just have to negate all this. So that will be false, true, false, false. And then finally, we will have to do this and Q. So I'm going to write down not P implying Q and Q. So we're looking at this and that. So this is true and false. So that will be false. False and true, that's false. True and false, that's false. False and false, that is false. So we get all false right here. What's this? This is a contradiction. Okay. Number 6, here we have P or Q implying P. Huh, we have P right here already. Implying P, shouldn't that just be always true? Well, let's have a look. Here is the truth table for it. P, Q, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. So true, true, false, false. True, false, true, false. Here we go for the first one. We have P or Q. True or true is true. True or false is true. False or true is still true. False or false, well, that will be false. Now, we are trying to get this implying P. And let me just write down P right here again. Because when I have an implication, I think it's just easier when we look at it from left to right. So P is true, true, false, false. And here we go. True implying true. Well, actually, let me write this down. P or Q implying P. Okay, here we go. True implying true, that is true. True implying true is true. But next, true implying false, that will be false. Lastly, false implying false, that is true. However, we do have a false here, so this is not always true. So this right here, it's not a tautology, and it's also not a contradiction. So this is a neither. So how can we change this to get a tautology though? Well, we will change the or to an and, and let's have a look. So that is going to be number 7. If the inside here is P and Q, implying P, this would be a tautology. So we have this already, and I will have an and here. So now, P and Q, true and true is true, true and false is false, false and true is false, false and false is false. And then P is still here. This is going to be P and Q implying P. Now let's have a look. True implying true, that is true. False implying true, hey, that is true now, because if the condition is false, then it doesn't really matter what happens after that, right? Likewise, false implying false is true. And lastly, false implying false is true. So, as we can see, this right here is a tautology. And that's it.